Once again, good morning everyone. This is Nishant Kumar from Birlasoft. So I'm working as a solution architect for the Birlasoft. So we'll move on to the topic, today's topic. So today I'm going to cover that how this contract logistics solution works. When I say the contract logistics, it's an integrated solution. So how this integrated solution between Oracle Transportation Management OTM and the Oracle WMS with that in the Logfire is working together. So generally we whenever we have the warehouse management system on any transportation system, we usually work as a silos. We don't have much integrated platform or the much integrated solution in place, because WMS warehouse management system is working in their own way, their inbound movement and outbound movement, and the transportation is working their own way of the execution of the transportation services. So that's why how this inbound and outbound movement is getting collaborated between the OTM and the WMS. And then added to that, we have one more functionality we have developed for customer, that is the 3PL billing, which is the one of the pain point currently within the customer for managing all 3PL billing on the WMS. So it has been developed on the top of the WMS and the OTM cloud. Let's start with that agenda. So what we are going to talk about for the next 30 minutes is the key challenges, what we have in the contract logistics, then how this integrated solution. So I'm just going to speak about some overall architecture, how the integration flows are working. Then we'll go this one level down, that some business flow of the inbound process and the outbound process and the 3PL billing, of course, that how we can manage within our OTM, WMS, and that the platform, the extended platform, what we have built it on top of these two applications. Then, of course, the key benefits, what we have got out through this whole solution journey. So let's talk about the key challenges. So the first challenge is obvious. We don't have the no comprehensive system to track end-to-end business between WMS and Oracle Transportation Management. That just now what I spoke about. And the second is how we are managing ASN or the purchase order or the sales order with accordance with the transportation. Because whenever we have any outbound movement or the inbound movement, always a transportation always comes into the picture. Because transportation, when our vehicle is going to be at a dock door, from where it is going to start, where it is going to be, in the case of inbound also, how the inbound process is going to be happen, but the outbound also, how much load this truck is going to be, which door it is, this truck is going to be, what are the capacity of these trucks. So these planning, we usually do it in the OTM, but we need to feed it to the warehouse management system. Okay, this is the truck is there, this is the planning, or this is the output of the planning, you have to stack the materials like this, these fit, we need to give it to the warehouse management as the team in the terms of the report or any information, like as they can create a sales order in their system, and then the further process of outbound and inbound process happens how in the WMS system. So, and the third is most of the challenging, the revenue leakage due to offline tracking of the 3PL rate agreement and the missing customer specific cycle. So this 3PL billing is one of the current most of the customers pain points. So we have rolled out this for one of the customers where the all 3PL billing is getting maintained. So when I say this 3PL billing, we all know all the storage charges of the warehouses or their handling in, handling out charges, whether it is a hazardous, whether it is a non-hazardous. So how this 3PL all this is going to make it, because their billing cycle is also very, it's not fixed, it's always a flexible. It's maybe the transactional basis, it may be the per day basis, it may be the weekly basis or the monthly basis or the quarterly basis. So how the automatically this whole process will work out, that at the end of the month we come to know, okay, these are the possible handling charges, these are the possible storage charges, and the automatically billing bill has to be generated and should get posted to the financial system. So this is the one of the challenges, and the back of the centralized billing system. So when we talk about the this whole invoicing and the billing process. If we are running 2-3 applications in the parallel, like Oracle Transportation Management, Warehouse Transportation Management, or any of the 3PL billing platform, then what is the best solution or the one way we can track all the invoicing and billing from the one application? There should be a centralized billing. So at the end of the day, when I want to take a report or when I want to take a profit calculation against cost and the revenue, we can see it at the one platform. Okay, these are the warehouses charges, these are the transportation charges, and we are getting. So that's why that also we have omitted out, and we have get a read of this, and we have decided to go with the centralized billing system as the OTM. We are taking all the warehouse related services like handling or their inbound outbound movement or their storage, all we are getting pushed to the OTM, and then all the approval process is being done into the OTM, and then it get posted to the financial system. And then of course the last is the lack of integrated solutions and the visibility, the overall visibility of the picture, that how transportation and the warehouse management system works. So if somebody wants to see the whole picture of the data set or in the terms of the report in the one centralized system, how they will get it done. So these are the basic challenges. So now coming to the solution components of these overcome these challenges. So if we see the central heart of this solution component is the OTM. So apart from the OTM, we have the Oracle WMS Cloud, we have the IoT, of course we have the FTI, we have our inbuilt billing platform, 3PL billing portal solution, then the Fusion Cloud, and Oracle WMS BI. So this is the overall component revolving around the Oracle Transportation Management, where we used these applications, or you can say the modules, to integrate with the Oracle Transportation Management. So let's go into that and see the overall architecture, that how it looks like. So when you say that OTM is there, so from OTM, the bi-directional interface is with Oracle WMS. This is the Logfire. And when we receive the order at a SO or PO in the OTM, then we will have order release, then shipment planning. Once the shipment got planned, then we'll send it further into the WMS. If it is inbound, then there is a receiving, then a quality check, then the put away, this process will happen. If it is outbound, then we will have a picking, packing, and the ship confirm. So these process will turn into the WMS, and it will get back to the OTM with the proper actual quantity. And then also all the freight from this WMS cloud, for all the transactions like handling in, handling out, or any of the storage, will also get updated with the 3PL billing platform, which is, you can see over there, where we have defined it, what are the service contract, what will be the billing rule, what are the approval process, and once all the calculation will done over there, it will get again pushed back to the OTM, and then subsequently all logistics, transportation, and the warehouse cost or the revenue will get interfaced to the financial system. So we had used Oracle Fusion Financial System, and of course left side of OTM there is a tracking system, which is IoT and the standard mobile app, which we have used for this solution as well. So coming to the next, we'll go to the one slide down. So this is the overall high level architecture or the flow. See here, you can see that this color depends OTM cloud, CPQ cloud, and the PaaS and ICS, WMS, and the financial cloud. So when we start this flow, this how this business process has commodated. Like when we receive the purchase order or the sales order as the order base. So we have received as the order base, then accordingly we release those orders. So when we create the order release, which is actually going to ship it. So once we create the order release, then it will go for the planning. Once the shipment get planned into the OTM, it will move into the warehouse system. So irrespective of whether it is the inbound movement or the outbound movement. So once this warehouse operations all picking, packing, kitting, replenishment, whatever the actual warehouse operations is there, once it happened at the WMS Oracle Cloud, then it moves to the 3PL billing. So whatever we have the transactional or the logs, so it moves over there as well, and it is a bi-directional with the OTM, and then finally all the costs will get captured into the OTM, where we are raising the invoice for the any of the vendor and for the billing for the customer, and then we'll have a tax calculation and then subsequently posting to the financial system. So here you can see also in that case for the warehousing or for the OTM, if we have quotation process, then we have implemented CPQ as well. So I'll not get into that mostly most on into the CPQ, but yes, when the customer get the request, we get the request at the inquiry, then we will have a long term or short term contract in the terms of the contract or the quotation. Then once it is get finalized, then it will get created in the 3PL billing cycle as a warehouse as a service contract, and in the OTM as a rate contract for the transportation. So this is how that if the CPQ is there, then it is a this process will start from here, because from the quotation, because we started from the quote to the cash cycle. So this is the quote quotation cycle. If we don't have any application to do the quotation, we do also have the quotation within the OTM also that we can also utilize for the transportation quotation purpose. So if it is not there, then we had given the flexibility to upload all the agreement and rates into the 3PL billing cycle, and of course in OTM is already there inbuilt. So let's go into one steps further down and looks, this is the inbound flow. So how this inbound flow is working, so all the import or any of the stock transfer or any of the returns or the CFS receiving or any of the ex-docs, so these anything for the import or the inbound movement, it comes into the OTM as an order base. Then we create another order ready. Then we usually had in the import moment, we have the custom clearance process. So then we did the custom clearance process into the OTM itself, and with the related document checks and there. So we had given at the order release level. So when it is done, then its shipment got created. Shipment got created, then it will be automatically, it will get interface into the warehouse management system. So this is the transmission, and we are tracking through the statuses. So once the planned shipment shipment got created, that planned shipment with all the related details, it will go into the warehouse management system, where we for the inbound, where we are tracking as a status, that ASN has got created, because we are also getting the acknowledgement that once the SO got created into ASN got created in the case of the inbound into the warehouse management system, we get it response back as a success, and then our status will works as it is. So this is once the shipment got created for the inbound, this is the flow for WMS warehouse management system. You can say that ASN will get created after the shipment case, and that interface will go. This ASN will get created, then we will have a entry and the doc assignment. Here, there is one more thing. In the OTM, we are doing the doc assignment. So we do have the functionality of the doc appointment and doc assignment. We know that it has also functionality in the WMS, Oracle WMS as well. But since this operation got started from the OTM, then once the shipment got planned, then we assign the dock from in which dock truck is going to be there in the warehouse, and that feed is getting into the WMS system, so that the warehouse management team also have to know that okay, this dock is already been assigned for this movement, inbound movement. So this is the dock and assignment checking over there, then we confirm the ASN and the GRN. So once it got confirmed, so and when we receive the material, then we as the inbound process, we have the all receiving, inspection, and then put away, and this all the process happens within the warehouse system. So this is the in Oracle warehouse system. You can say that once the interface get triggered to the warehouse management system, The first is in transit, then subsequently the status got changed and it got created as a ASN got created. So here the ASN got created. The moment it got created, it will get back to the OTM as a status that ASN got created for the inbound system. So that the OTM and the warehouse management both are on the same at the status level. We are in the at the shipment level. In the OTM, we are maintaining this inbound movement tracking. And this is again one more information we usually get it. In the case of inbound, suppose as a planned shipment, we are about to receive 100 packets, and we send it to the WMS. But actual receiving happens only 45 because of any of the reasons. Packets got misplaced or damaged. But actually, in the WMS inventory at the inbound, we received a 45 packet. So that 45 will also get back updated to the OTM as that quantity, actual quantity, because that only 45 on that the billing is going to happen. So that's we are also tracking this as the planned quantity and the actual quantity. So that is also getting back updated into the OTM. So the same way we are also doing the outbound flow when we receive the order as a order base as a SO, then we release order release. Then once the shipment will get created, it will go to the warehouse management system to create a SO in the WMS. So once the whole outbound process happens in the WMS, then the actual loaded quantity, because in the same for outbound also, when we plan the quantity as per the truck capacity, suppose 100 packets, but actual loading has happened only 95 packets, so that could be happened, so that the actual quantity, what is the what has been loaded into the truck, and with that actual quantity, when at the warehouse management in that application, when users do ship confirm. So on that event, ship confirm with that actual quantity and those status will come back to the OTM.
Sure. So in the WMS, are you sending the orders as well, or are you mapping through the shipment?
Yeah, through the shipment case. From the it's not order as the order management we are using at the OTM at the order base as the SO, ASN or the PO we are receiving. So suppose sometimes we receive the SO like 100 packets, but we need to release only 50 or 40. So like that, that's why we model at the order base because of the scalability solution. And then once we release order release and when we plan the shipment, so on that plan shipment we are sending all those details.
So that's the first time the WMS sees the orders through our planned shipment.
Correct. And there the ASN, PO, or SO, it will get created into the WMS. Okay. So this is the same transmission or the interface is getting triggered from OTM to WMS. So the status same we are maintaining. And then once the outbound shipment will get transferred or they get integrated to the WMS. You can see the process flow. This is within the WMS. So if it is a stock transfer, then we have the other process flow, because in the stock internal stock transfer, if you have for one warehouse, it will be the outbound, for other warehouse, it will be the inbound. For the one warehouse, it will be ACO, is the sales transfer order. For the other warehouse, it will the facilities what we define within the Logfire or the Oracle WMS is it will create a SN for other warehouse.
So, so are you splitting the shipment that's coming out into the two loads?
Yep.
For the stock transfer?
Yes. Yep. So if it is, this is a prerequisite, if it is a stock transfer, how many quantities getting the stock transfer out is, how many it is going to be at the sales order at the outbound. So that we are splitting and we are sending to that identified to the WMS. And then again, when it got the SO creation, when the pick list generation on the basis of the pick list, then we the picking, packing and staging process happens. So when it's got loaded into the ship, then we have the readian confirmation from the WMS, and once it get the ship confirmed, then it will again come back to the OTM with the actual quantity. Okay, this much is already loaded into the truck and it is ship confirmation from There. So this is some screenshots from WMS cloud. So once we send it back to the from land shipment to the WMS, it got created. Then we have got the picking method. Whatever we can choose this picking method to take out for the outbound. Then once it is loaded and the status will become shipped. So on that status, it will get again triggered back to the OTM with the that ship confirmed on that particular shipment. Then the further execution of that particular tracking of that particular shipment happens. Then the events and the tracking, then we also have connected with the IoT, because once the truck starts, then actual execution process starts. So when it got delivered, then we have the proof of delivery and all those concepts through the mobile app and the IoTs. And then when it gets finally delivered, then we have the billing process. So this is basically for the outbound and inbound process. So next thing, what I spoke about the 3PL billing. So this is the 3PL billing framework. So on the left side, you can see this is the all warehouse management system, the Oracle warehouse, where we are having outbound movement, inbound movement, and we also have internal movement or the storage or the uses. So, and this is the framework what we have built it on the on top of the WMS cloud as a 3PL model application. So how it works? So we define it, we categorize it the four into four part. First we define it the pricing, both the pricing list at that 3PL billing. So when I say the pricing, the contract what we have with the customer, so the rates. So how the pricing could be any per CBM. Pricing can be a per kg, per metric ton, or any specific space, or the per day basis, or because the way the storage pricing usually get contracted with the customer. Then we have defined some billing contracts. So those rules, billing rules, we have defined like how the calculation is going to happen. So that rules we have defined. So might be if I am doing the handling charges. So handling for non-hazardous commodity would be a different, for the hazardous commodity would be the different. So if we have any storage charges, their rules would be the calculation rules would be the different. So then we have the activity logs. What is this activity logs? Is the bunch of old transactions which is happening in the WMS, because how many handling happened for a month, how many handling out happens in a month, how many storage happens for that particular customer for this month. So that data we require it from here. So we have taken the file-based approach, integration file-based approach, where the end of the day we are taking all the data and we are getting pushed to over here. Because if we have the all transactional data, then those billing rules and that pricing will help calculate. And then we also have defined the billing frequency, because some of the customer wants per day bill, some of the customer wants transaction wise bill, some of the customer wise wants monthly bill, and some customer wants quarterly bill. So again, so every customer might be one customer. If I am the customer and I have the two services with my third party, the one service is for handling in, handling out, and second is the storage services. For me, I want you, okay, give me the storage services billing month wise, but handling out, handling in, you just give me the weekly wise, whatever the bill or the handling happens during the outbound and inbound movement. So this is why we have make this billing rules or the frequency we have defined at the our bolt-on application, and that is all automatic. So this all process is automatic. We just need to schedule the billing process. Okay, on this date this bill is going to be triggered. So all the calculation and everything happens automatically. So all the rules and everything would have been done. Sorry. So this is the overall that how this 3PL billing process flow works. So at the left side, you can say this is the transportation and the WMS application. Right side, at this on the top, if you see, these three are the rules what we just spoke about. So these we have defined it on that application. So once it start, then we will see. We also given in the manual options and the auto options also, because we they want to give us the, some flexibility, because sometimes it's auto billing is fine, they want it, but in the some scenario they want to change something from the UI side, so they want to put it at the manual stuff as well. So that calculation should be on the manual side, so that also we have given. So once it got auto, so automatically it will trigger all the rules, services attached, or the pricing list attached. And once it got all at the rule calculations, then it will go for the counters. Counters is nothing but how many counts has been done for that particular services. So that counters like handling in, how many handling in has been done, handling out, how many handling out has been done, storage facilities. So these counters come to that in 1 month, these are the transaction has been made in the WMS cloud, and then on that calculation it will get calculated, and it, all this calculation done at the 3PL Boltron application, it will get pushed to the OTM. So in OTM we receive the transactions as a shipment. So if it is outbound or inbound movement, we will getting this additional cost line of handling charges will get added to that particular shipment also. Then you guys must be thinking that how they will not to know to come to know that which sales shipment against which sales shipment they have to add this additional line. So when we are sending the SO or to create a plan shipment, that only time the sales shipment ID is with them. So that sales shipment ID from WMS cloud, it goes to 3PL billing application, because every time it got synced when we send the transactional data, and then again that sales shipment ID there for the handling charges. If there is only storage charges billing is happening, so we are creating a sales shipment as a SAW shipment. So in the OTM we are getting as a SAW shipment is so SAW shipment where you don't require any order and order release and order base to be created. But the only those for the storage charges, we are creating a SAW shipment into OTM. Then we will have a tax calculation, approval flows, and then it will go to the financial system. After this, this is the overall 3PL billing, you can say that screen. The first screen is the agreement creation. So when we do the contractual agreement with the customer, so how we can create it. So we have given all the who is the bill to party, what are the contacts, what are the details. So which we have also given Excel upload functionality to that, because in the case of it is going through the CPQ, all the contract and agreement is placed there, it is directly integrated to this platform. If in the case the contract or agreement is not happening with the CPQ, so then we have given the Excel based upload functionality where user can upload at a time the Excel based functionality for the large volume, all the contract. So if this looks like that, how if you want to search any existing agreement from that screen, then through company name or the contract number or the status, you can search, and that all the details will come that this is from how many duration this contract is existing, 1 year, 2 year, or 5 months. This is the line level duration activity. As I mentioned, that might be one customer has a multiple line of agreement. So maybe first is handling in, second agreement is different for handling out, third agreement for the storage, or fourth agreement related to the usage, and all the basis or the rules will be different. Something for the per CBM basis, some agreement would be per KG basis, or some agreement would be per metric ton basis, or some space related basis. So that line we can define it, or every lines also give the counter details that for this time how many handling in services has been done. So this all transactional stuff is coming from the WMS every evening, and all the counters will get updated. So, okay, this many of handling out and this many of storage moment happened within the warehouse system. This is also, you can say, the billing rules or the billing source, how to define all the billing, handling in, handling out, this storage billing. So these all as we define, this charge code is nothing but our accessorial code what we define, and these all charge codes are getting synced with the OTM as well. OTM, financials, and this WMS, all these charge code are getting fixed, because upon this charge code, again this charge code, GL code has defined within the financial system. So this is one of the approval flows. for a certain billing contract or the agreement which is getting uploaded manually. Because if it is coming through the CPQ, there is approval flow itself there before getting the contract. But if something is getting manually, then we have also given the additional approval flow cycle where the manager can approve, okay, this agreement is fine. And they can also see the, all the billing details over there in that particular dashboard, that how many handling in, what is the transaction number, what is the interface date, or when we transmitted for the billing purpose. So these things are already covered for the providing the dashboard. And this is the last that what we were talking about, the frequency of the billing, how we are getting schedule. So here you can define the schedule, okay, per month, 1 month. So like this, 1 month for the year, it is already getting scheduled 3rd April to 2nd May. On the 2nd May, it will automatically calculate all the billing related to that particular customer, handling itself, storage, whatever services are there, and it will get interfaced into the OTM. Also, we have also given that two options, like offset day invoice, offset day interface. What does that mean? That means sometimes customer wants that, okay, it will get triggered on 2nd of the December, but my invoice has to raise up after 5 days. But my invoice date should be on the, the invoice PDF, it should be a 7. So that's why it will get calculated till 2nd of the December, but your invoice will get raised on the 7th of the December. So that logic is there. So that it will also calculate automatically the invoice date. Also, if some requirement is there, I want the billing has to be calculated transaction basis. So just only we need to make it this checkbox, and that transaction, every transaction you will get the billing for that particular customer. So again, it depends the how the contract and agreement has been done with the customer. It is the transaction base, or the daily base, or the weekly base, or the monthly base. Accordingly, we can schedule those billings, and once it will get scheduled, get calculated, it will fetch into the OTM as a shipment. So in the case of outbound invoice, it will be the, again the same shipment. And in the case of storage, it will be a short shipment into the OTM, and then we will have a billing creation as a standard process, a standard approval flow, tax calculation, and posting into the financial system. So this is how the OTM screenshot. So once it got scheduled, get interface, this is the additional charge lines added. This is the transportation charge, we have already planned it. And this is the handling charge, what we have received once it has done for that particular customer. So this is only for the outbound inbound services. In the case of storage, it will be a short shipment, sale as a short shipment, and it will be a one line for storage charges. Yeah. So we created a bill into the OTM, and this is a screenshot of Oracle Fusion. So once we post it, how it looks like into the Oracle Fusion. So this is the whole, just what I wanted to you understand, this is the whole integrated cycle. Start from the OTM, goes to WMS, WMS update back to the OTM. The transaction will take on the 3PL billing cycle, where all the calculation happens, it comes into the OTM as a shipment. Then the billing will get generated into the OTM, approval process happens, and then integrated to the Fusion financial system. So this is how it looks like in the final settlement, which happens from there. This is a couple of dashboard what we have created for that particular customer to see the overall picture. So these data is our WMS data is also present in our system, and in the Oracle Transportation Management, or related to specific to WMS, we can take it out from the WMS, and also we have the 3PL billing from where we can also take out the dashboard. Last but not the least, the key benefit, we have the fully integrated cloud-based service to manage the transportation with warehouse services, fully configurable in the case of ASN, PO, SO covering the different scenario. We try to utilize or improve the utilization of the docs scheduling or the docs appointment from OTM to the WMS. We have the rule-based and system-driven receiving and put away for picking and warehouse. That is the inbuilt factory for the warehouse. The major thing is 3PL provider, be able to capture the rate, separate invoice, automated billing, and the last is the centralized billing. So one place, that is the OTM, we are doing the centralized billing. So net to net, we have the integrated, intelligent, comprehensive, and the meaningful, and the highly visible solution. Thank you so much. It was something in between the technical glitch. But that's all from my side. If we have any questions, just feel free to ask.